The nearly five-year halt of operations of the Philippine National Railways set to begin after the Christmas season this year. This is to speed up the construction of the North to South Railway projects aimed at modernizing the country's train system. On Sunday, the railway's Alabang to Calamba route was suspended. Starting July 15, all remaining trips along this route will fully stop, affecting at least 500 daily train commuters. The PNPI is deploying emergency buses to help affected passengers. An oil price rollback is expected this week. Estimates show a liter of gasoline and kerosene will be cheaper by at least 70 centavos. Diesel prices may also go down by as much as 80 centavos. The Philippine National Police Anti-Cybercrime Group says four Chinese fugitives were among the persons arrested in a raid in Las Piñas last week. Authorities, though, did not provide additional details. The PNP is currently in the process of filing charges against several hundred foreign workers and local contacts apprehended in the sweep at a Philippine offshore gaming operator center. The PNP said it also prevented an escape attempt by several foreigners. And meanwhile, a lawyer for some of the apprehended individuals has decried the alleged maltreatment by police of several foreign nationals in the raid. But the PNP denies the allegations, saying a maximum tolerance was implemented during the entire operation. The controversy in the latest tourism campaign of the Philippine government, advertising agency DDB Philippines apologizing over its apparent use of non-original and stock footage in the tourism department's video for its new slogan, Love the Philippines. It says the presentation was meant to be a nude video to excite internal stakeholders about the campaign, adding no public funds were used for it. The agency also calls its use of stock footage an unfortunate oversight, highly inappropriate and contradictory to the tourism department's objectives. The DOT earlier said it was conducting an exhaustive probe on DDB's alleged use of stock footage, following accusations of the video clips used in the ad from other countries like Thailand, Indonesia, and Dubai. Representative Joey Saceda also weighing on the ad campaign mess. He says this proves the lousy work done on the new tourism campaign of the Philippine government. Saceda also saying plagiarism cannot set the mood in tourism ads in the country. Saceda earlier called out the tourism department for failing to include Albay's Mayon volcano in the country's latest marketing campaign. An update now on the Mayon volcano unrest. State volcanologists warn residents within the volcano's 7 to 8 kilometer danger zone to prepare for possible evacuation. Now, this comes amid an increase in volcanic quakes and pyroclastic density current in the area. Mayon Volcano Observatory resident volcanologist Paul Alanis said these activities were monitored at the Basud Gully of the volcano, which faces the area of Legazpi City and Darata and Santo Domingo in Albay Province. Now, the status of the Mayon Volcano is still placed under alert level 3. Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica. What happens?
Good morning, Ms. Nikki, and to all of our audience. So, as of now, easterlies is affecting Visayas and Mindanao. And because of easterlies, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and a thunderstorm over Caraga, Davao region, northern Mindanao, Leyte, southern Leyte, and Bohol. And for the weather in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting better weather conditions where there are chances of localized thunderstorms, especially during the afternoon and the evening. As of now, we don't have any gale warning raised in any part of our country, so our fishermen and those with small sea vessel can venture to the ocean. And we're currently not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone inside our Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica Torres.
All right, thanks for that update, Veronica.